हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक वेरिएशन इन वैल्यू ऑफ जी. फर्स्ट ए दैट दे हैव गिवन द चेंज अलोंग द सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ. सो वैल्यू ऑफ जी, हाउ दैट इज चेंज अलोंग विद द सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ, दैट वी हैव टू सी इन दिस पॉइंट. विल द वैल्यू ऑफ जी बी द सेम एवरीवेयर और द सरफेस ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ? The answer is no, because the reason is that the shape of the earth is not exactly spherical, and so the distance of a point on the surface of the earth from its center different somewhat from place to place. Due to its rotation, the earth bulges at the equator and it's flattened at the poles. See here, they have given that is value of the G is not same at the all places on the surface of the earth. Means it is different. But how it is different? Then because of the shape of the earth is not exactly spherical. And that's why the point on the surface of the earth from its center different somewhat from place to place. Here I have drawn the one figure. Maybe it's an spherical completely, but Earth's shape is not completely spherical. You know that though somehow that is oval shape we can see there. When we can calculate the value of G from the center of the Earth, that is different. So here that is different from here. If you are measuring, that is different from here. That will become different. This is the actually equator of the earth, and from this equator they are measuring the radius of the earth, and this is the actually this place we can call the pole of the earth. So here also a different value of G, and this place also at the equator also we can see the different value of the G. Due to its rotation, the earth bulges at equator and it flatter at the poles. They said due to the rotation, so earth is rotated like this way, rotation. So earth, due to its rotation, it bulges at the equator and flatter at the pole. Here that show the flatter at the pole and bulges at the equator. Its radius is largest at the equator and smaller at the poles. So its radius is larger at the equator because it's bulges this place, and the smaller from if we measure from here to here, it is at the pole it is smaller, and this here the radius is more is there on at the equator. So that they have given here, the its radius largest at the equator and smallest at the poles. The value of G is thus highest, 9.832 meter per second square at the poles, and decreases slowly with the decreasing latitude. It is lowest 9.78 meter per second square at the equator, and that is why the value of G that is highest at the pole here, that they have given, that is value of G is 9.832 meter per second square, and it is decreases at the equator. They have given that value of G here, 9.78 meter per second square. And here that showed that at the equator we can see that lowest G's value, that is decreases from pole to equator. Then next B, change with height. As we go above the earth's surface, the value of R in equation 5 increases and the value of G decreases. However, the decrease in the rather small for heights which are small in comparison to the Earth's radius. For example, remember that the radius of the Earth is 6400 km. If an aeroplane is flying at a height 10 km above the surface of the Earth, its distance from the Earth's surface changes from 6400 to the 6410 kilometers, and the change in the value of g due to it is negligible. On the other hand, when we consider the artificial satellite orbiting the Earth, we have to take into account the change in the value of g due to the large change in the distance of satellite from the center of the Earth, some typical heights and the value of g at these heights are given in the following table. So we have given the table there. Before that, we will understand first what we have given here. They said, as we go above the Earth's surface, the value of r, that is in equation 5 they have given, that is increases, and the value of g decreases. They have given the example of aeroplane also. If the radius of Earth that is 6400 kilometer, an aeroplane that is flying about the 10 kilometer above the surface of the Earth, then the distance of the Earth surface changes. That will from 6400 kilometer to 6410 kilometers, and the value of g that will be negligible. First they have given the r, that value of r increases and value of g is decreases. Let's we understand through this diagram. A rough diagram I have drawn here. If any aeroplane is flying like this way from the surface of the Earth, then the value of r, that is increases, means the radius that will be increases, and the g's value that will decreases, and maybe it will negligible, I mean it's come the zero. Negligibles we cannot count that one. So the value of r is increases and the value of g is decreases, like this, or the surface of the Earth. That is they have given in this information related to that. When the aeroplane is flying from the height of the 10 kilometer from the surface of the Earth, then the radius, that is increases, and the gravitation, that is g, is decreasing, means the g values, there is a decreasing. On the other hand, they have given about the artificial satellite orbiting the Earth. Artificial satellite also moving or orbiting side of the Earth. Then the distance of the satellite from the center of the Earth, some typical heights and the values of g at these heights are given in the following table. So what will be the value of g, and that we have given in the next table there, that we will see. Students, see here, they have given the places, height, and that is in kilometer, and g value, that is in meter per second square, that unit they have given here. Then the places, where the surface of the Earth, average height means zero, at the surface means the zero, that height, and its value of g, that is 9.8 meter per second square. Then the at the Mount Everest, the height 8.8 kilometer, and the value of g is there, that is also 9.8 meter per second square. Maximum height reaches by man-made balloon, that will 36.6 kilometer, and the value of g will come 9.77 meter per second square. Then the height of the typical weather satellite, that is 400 kilometer, and value of g will come 8.7. height of कम्युनिकेशन सैटेलाइट दैट इज 35,700 किलोमीटर एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ जी इज देयर 0.225. हियर द टेबल शोइंग चेंज ऑफ जी विथ हाइट अबाउ द अर्थ सरफेस. सो द हाउ द चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ जी अबाउ द अर्थ सरफेस दैट वी हैव गिवन इन दिस टेबल. देन नेक्स्ट सी वी हैव गिवन द चेंज विद द डेप्थ. द वैल्यू ऑफ जी ऑल्सो चेंजेस इफ वी गो इन साइड द अर्थ नॉट ओनली द ऑन द सर्फेस और वेन वी आर गोइंग अबाउ द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ एट द हाइट देर द वैल्यू ऑफ जी विल चेंज बट द एट द डे इन द वेन यू आर गोइंग इन साइड द अर्थ दैट टाइम ऑल्सो द जी वैल्यू इज चेंजेस. द वैल्यू ऑफ आर इन इक्वेशन 5 डिक्रीजेस एंड वन वुड थिंक दैट द वैल्यू ऑफ जी शुड इंक्रीजेस एज पर द फॉर्मूला. However, the part of the earth which contributes towards the gravitational force felt by the object also decreases, which means that the value of m to be used in the equation, there we have used the value of m means the mass of the earth. They have given in that equation, so 5 also that is decreases. As a combined result of change in R, that is radius and mass, the value of G decreases as we go deep inside the earth. So here by the rough diagram we will check that it how it will change. So this is the actually surface of the earth, and when you are going down or deep inside the center of the earth, there the value of G be change, or they said that is decreases at the center if you are going. They have given the R that is decreases. The radius also decreases at the center of the earth here. The R that is also decreases. And this said that is R and M, that mass of the earth, this is the actually mass, and R that is decreases as well as the here G also that is decreases, means the value of G at the center of the earth is zero. And they have given the equation 5, they said the G is equal to, we have given that is G M upon R square. So there R that is decreases and the G, the universal gravitation that will be increases. So the value of G, this one here, the capital G, see here children, so, and here they have given about the small g, the value of the gravitation, and this is the universal gravitation. So this value at the center of the earth, that it decreases or it will come zero. So answer of this question I have already given to you. Then next we will see that every planet and satellite has different mass and radius. Hence according to equation 6, the values of G on their surface are different. On the moon it is about 1/6 of the value on the earth. As a result, using same amount of force, we can jump 6 times higher on the moon as compared to that on the earth. So it means that the value of G is different on the moon and different on the earth, and that's why we can jump 6 times higher on the moon as compared to that on the earth.